It's been relatively a long way, starting from a quarantine boredom idea from a year that cannot be named to until this moment. Like most of you, I've gone through a shitty period, and to be honest, it helped a little. And by now I know that it also helped many old strangers who watched my crap. Today we're gonna do a final update on my X project, a camera not that we need, but which we deserve. What up guys, it's Aperture Value, and first of all, I wanna salute all the people that subscribed and watched me so far. It's really supporting and inspiring. So many of you were curious about my X project and some had decent ideas and suggestions. For the newcomers, you probably have no idea what is going on. And I'm sorry because this info requires initiation, but don't worry, no naked races or tattooing logo required. It would be dope though. The best way is just to check my previous episodes on X Project. Now back to the point. It's been half a year since I posted a video mentioning X Project, and I've got a ton of helpful feedback, and I even put up a guest article on Fuji Rumors website, which was absolutely unbelievable. Cheers, Patrick. I couldn't even think this idea will resonate with so many of you. I hope this quick video will be kind of a logical end. First of all, let's talk about exterior. Unfortunately, my paint job didn't last as long as I anticipated, just like my first relationship. It started to chip and get dirty, so I went a known way. I got rid of it altogether and polished it to the level of Daft Punk. It took a lot of sandpaper. I also refilled engravings with black paint. Another f*** up was a cracked viewfinder glass, and so because I had to disassemble camera anyway, I replaced it with an acrylic glass cutout. It would be perfect to find an original replacement part since it has some anti-glare and UV coatings, but they don't seem to exist. Here I had to work with what I have. Next update concerns my X-Pen mask for our sensor. Obviously, my design is far from being perfect, so one of my viewers contacted me and been interested in working on it. Check his Instagram, he's an enthusiast hobby photographer who dabbles in old camera and lens repairs and designs lens mounts to adapt uncommon optics to his Fuji. Later he proposed an improved version with beveled edges and better masking. Let's call it Mark 2. My Mark 1 mask is 2mm thick, so it fits somewhat tight between sensor and lens, which made sure that it won't move or rotate inside. It works with all the native Fuji X mount glass, but few of the viewers noted that while adapting some of the Leica lenses, it can cause some problems due to protruding rear elements reaching sensor further than Fuji lenses. To be honest, if you have Leica glass, buying a real X-Pen shouldn't be a problem for you folks. But anyway, to address this issue, the Mark II is just 1mm thick or thin. To ensure a secure position inside, I used a tiny piece of blue tack to fix it inside. Now many of you pointed out that a dark material should be used for printing the mask, but unfortunately, the ones I've found locally cannot be printed too thin, therefore the sharp edges of a redesigned mask opening can't be done. So the best way would be just to print it with any material available capable of designed minimum thickness, and then just paint it black. I've tested Mark II with a 16-80mm lens. Here you can see the image at f4 throughout the range. And also at f8. Comparing the shots with Mark 1, you can tell that improvement does take place here. The vignette is more contrasty and shows less fading. Well, I figure to conclude everything to a logical end, as I've said before, X-Pen shots ain't really working out for me, but it surely does engage some of you. So enjoy this little update, consider it a curtain call, and get ready for new cool projects and reviews coming, I promise. Meanwhile, make sure you follow me on Instagram, since if there will be any further update, I'll be just posting it there instead of making another video. And of course, as before, I'll be posting a download link for the Mark II in the description below so you can print it out for yourself, completely free. Well, almost. Just promise me to subscribe to this channel, otherwise you'll miss focus every shot until the rest of your life.